take inner vision or insight, and now you can start to understand that the only way that you can...
People that weren't in there talking about, they're really serious about knowing something about reparations, they're not here. So since you're making a lot of commentaries about different things, you might make a commentary about that.
Okay.
The fact that we've gone out of our way to set something up to help them to learn about something they say they really want to know about. Then you private messaged to one of them, so I'm hoping they agreed to come to class.
You gotta have a lot, they don't need it.
So now, what we can definitely say is, actions actually speak louder than words.
Yeah.
So I'm just saying, you can make a comment on that. But anyway, what we're dealing with is, they looked up the word reparation.
Mm-hmm.
What they found out is that there is, it seems to be no etymology for the word reparation.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I can tell them how to deal with the fact that they're not going to find an etymology on this word.
I thought it was reparation instead of reparation.
No, you didn't really listen.
Well, I see.
To what I'm trying to get you to hear.
All right, well.
What I said was, since you couldn't find an etymology for reparation, before I tell you what to do, we are going to perform an exercise. The word that we're going to look up is healthy. When you look up healthy, you should not be able to find an etymology for the word healthy. Then what we thought to ask is to ask them, well, what do you think you should do when you look up the word healthy and you do not find an etymology bracket for the word? I'm sorry, James? And then Brandon suggested to you all that you just go to the word health, which is what you did, right? Right? Okay, so what did you find when you made it to the word health? What did you find? You want to tell me? You can tell me, Taylor. You don't want to tell me? Alright. You found whole, sound, and what?
Well.
And well. Okay, good.
So do you
but the thing
to
is, do I want what?
To look at, take the TH.
Not yet.
Okay.
What I'm trying to do first, see, here's what I'm really doing. You know how you always thought your child, James, is supposed to learn because you tell him. Huh? People do not children, not adults. No one will learn because you tell them.
Mr. Brown.
Yes.
I'm gonna leave in the back room.
All right.
Well, no, that's the reason I just walked out of the room. It's what you just said. I just explained that identical thing to them, is that me attempting to explain to you or anybody doesn't mean that they'll know.
Because trust me, there's no such thing as explained in the way that you have been taught what it is. It is just not possible. You have to teach yourself things. That's the way they're going to learn. He's not going to learn because you tell him anything.
Well, but you know what, though, man?
Yes.
I don't care how many times you repeat that. It's something in the brain, at least was in my brain, that really doesn't believe that ignition.
No, it's no problem. But that's only because you made it to around 50, 60, whatever it is, before you actually start trying to adjust it.
Hold on, man. I was a little bit younger than
How old are you?
About 40.
All right. We'll give you 40.
Thank you, Ms. Bell.
Well, that's, listen, that is a lot of years for the brain to absorb something that we're now going to try to correct. And you have not been a part of correcting anything over the last couple of hundred years. Mm. So it's really been ingrained in such a way where now it's almost genetic. It's almost a part of the DNA. And we're having problems trying to work this out. But the only way we can work this out, Daniel, Taylor, James, maybe Jasmine, the only way we can work this out is if we start young enough. Mm-hmm. How old was Taj when I started with Taj? Does anyone know?
In the womb.
Taj was in the womb. How old did we start, Daniel?
So when I was five.
Five? Were you five? Were you five?
How old are you now?
Ten.
You ten?
He was about,
maybe
yeah,
five.
About five.
I thought it might have been more, but did
yeah,
you?
Yeah, he was five.
Five?
You had Nacho first, and then he
was I had Nacho first, and then he was coming.
Nacho was about 14.
Mm-hmm. But now the object is, you're a little old, James, Taylor, Daniel, Jasmine. You almost old people. So you can imagine how this is with the rest of us, all right? It's better that we actually get started before they actually materialize, before they manifest. See, next time you have another one, I'm talking to your mama, not Jane. Next time you have another one,
there's not a next time. I'm having another one. I'm sure you
will. You don't have anything to do with that.
Okay.
All right. Next time, you're going to do something that I'm trying to ask you to do. You're going to make sure that you find the closest thing to Superman that you can identify in the male counterpart for the reproduction.
Yes, you were right about that.
It has to be the closest thing. Now understand. Understand, if you just having a good time and you're not paying attention to some other things.
Oh, I am.
Okay. All right, but now all I'm just saying is when it happens in the future, you have to plan for it and prepare for it. Because what you're doing now is you're trying to create, for real, Superman. In other words, Taylor, does Superman have to be a male in order for it to be Superman? So are you telling me that Superman can be a female? Why?
Because it doesn't have to be a male.
I can't hear you.
It doesn't have to
talking be a male. To the microphone.
It doesn't have to be a man.
Why not?
It doesn't matter which gender it is.
Good, good. Because both male and female are what?
Humans.
No. No, no, please do not attempt to be a human. Please don't do that. Don't you dare let anybody talk you into being a human. And do not argue about it. So if they are having that discussion, you be quiet. You got it? You just be quiet. But you're right. It doesn't have to deal with the gender. It's man. And man is both what? Both what?
Genders.
And what genders are we referring to?
A man and a woman.
I want you to call the genders by the gender identification. What do you call it? What do you call man?
Male. A male,
and what do you call woman?
A female.
Thank you. And male and female are both man. You got it?
Yes, sir.
And the word man is the word mind. And it is because you think. You are sentient and you are sapient. Now, it has to be Superman that you provide this particular existence. All right? So anyway, what I'm trying to tell your mama is, in the future, just like we started with Taj, before he even got here, in the future, what we've got to do is actually start with each other before the next one comes. Now, I do know that the public schools are waiting until they're, how old, Jasmine?
How old are you?
To teach them about how to
read.
What?
Read.
Read. How do they have to be to read in public school?
Second grade.
Oh, public school teach them about second grade?
Third grade.
And I'm suggesting that I go around people where they can't read coming out of high school. And reading is just one power.
It doesn't take that long.
It doesn't take what long?
It doesn't take a system to systematize a brain to learn. By the time I got Daniel to work with me, he was in a structure. He was in a systematic structure from the system that built that brain.
You mean for him not to actually want to learn?
For him to, okay, so here's the thing. Daniel, when he was coming to you, he was... We were working with him, but he knew what learning was. He was curious, he explored, he learned, and knew as real time. When we put him in the system, he lost that curiosity.
You're saying the system actually programs them to behave in such a way where they don't want to learn.
Right. So learning is at a specific time and place and box and uses of being.
And so,
same with me.
So what I'm suggesting is that what we're hopefully doing is making sure that we can start with our babies, with our children. And then Brandon has been working really diligently to try to get all of the parents to understand that they need to stop beating on their babies.
Yes, sir.
You still getting beaten, Stephen? No? Good. But you do everything you're supposed to do, right? So you should never get beat on if you're doing everything you're supposed to do. What about you, James? You still getting beat on? All right, so I know you're gonna start doing everything you gotta do, right? Huh? Because you don't want to get beat on, do you? All you got to do is start expressing your power. Daniel, you getting beat on? Really? So I know you're doing everything you're supposed to do, right? Is that right?
It wouldn't be
though. All right. But anyway, what we're doing by trying to work with our little bitty ones before they ever materialize, and all the way through this, we're trying to actually groom Superman to use its powers. Daniel, and by the way, what is Superman? How would you identify Superman? Give me any way you want to identify. Do it the best way you can. How would you identify Superman? That's a good thing. She's looking it up. But now, you might use Webster's definition of Superman. And that's not even Webster's dictionary now. Webster actually stopped after the 1827. And even with the 1827, He trained and taught lexicographers. See, there's no way that any one person could actually edit all of the inserts that goes into a dictionary. Yes? I'm sure they should.
It may have just gone.
What?
It was
on. Fact and opinion.
Anybody who think that a fact and an opinion is the same thing, knucklehead. A nut. Anybody that thinks that belief and knowledge are the same thing, knucklehead. Now, I am suggesting that some of my students are actually on the verge of being knuckleheads because there are people putting into their brains that belief and knowledge are the same thing. They are not. So mind and brain are not the same thing. World and planet are not the same thing. As long as you're walking around here talking about the world and you're placing it in a position where it should be, growing up pretty much most of 70 years. And all my life, people have been telling me that they're going to send me down to the office to get some discipline. And when you get down there, somebody got a paddle, a belt. Your parents got extension cords. And they're going to discipline you. So then I just asking the question, how did it get to be the same thing?
I don't know, because my grandmother always called it punishment.
Your grandmother called it punishment. You are one in a million, and you are lucky to be one in a million. And Daniel, you may want to actually practice with someone who has the good fortune of being one in a million. You got it?
Is it because like self-discipline is like deciding what you're going to do and what you're not? Well, I'll let you do it first.
You said self-discipline.
Go ahead, Mr. Brown.
I don't know why this thing won't answer. I'll have to call him back later. Self-discipline. Now, what is self-discipline?
The best way I could describe it is choosing actions that will benefit you.
Did you read Violence in the Promised Land? Did you read Discipline, Violence in the African American Child? Well, that'll help you with the discussion, all right?
But where I was getting at was that when you have self-discipline, suppose you're able to make decisions that benefit you and get rid of bad habits. So
that's a good way to say that. Who taught you how to say it like that?
I just said it. I didn't know.
I understand. Well, here's the way I'm going to say it to you. Discipline, especially what she just said, self-discipline, Daniel, is when you have self-control. Now, why am I saying that to you, Daniel? You don't know. Because you need to practice self-control.
Okay, so here's the problem. What defines self-control? There has to be some parameters set, because according to him, his self-control is according to the way he lives.
Well, good, but he lives in a social order.
Absolutely.
His mother is trying to get him to actually conform to certain things in the social order. All right, now, the best way to determine discipline, give me the word that it comes from, Taylor. Give me the word that discipline comes from. James? What? Give me the word that the word discipline comes from. Oh, good. Go write it on the board. One of you, write it on the board.
And we
while he's doing it, explain to me what it is that I'm asking you.
Discipline.
Are you having a problem spelling discipline?
Discipline.
So to answer your question, where did discipline actually come from? You just said it.
From
the word disciple. So now we've got to go in and figure out what the story of the disciples is really about. Can you do that?
That it means to the word discipline?
The word discipline actually is going to be an extension of the word disciple. What is the story about?
The disciples?
Yes, the disciples.
Isn't suffering and martyrdom? That was the
new disciple. Does it have something to do with like measurements? Like, because it's 12 of them?
It's not 12.
Well,
it starts out 70.
70?
70. 70, not 12.
What they do to get...
What?
How do others get kicked out?
No one gets kicked out of anything. What you are relying on is a misconception and a bad story.
Well, I was at work today, and a guy was just talking, and he said something along the lines that he's glad that he doesn't get periods and have to give birth. And someone else said they was like, that's because of sin.
Wow. So now, what I want you to try to do, I want you to try to learn how to, whenever people are talking like that, you learn how to be quiet.
I didn't say nothing.
Don't say anything. Stay out of it. Leave it alone. Matter of fact, you ought to get somewhere safe.
But why? Would people who had an idea of patriarchy, like, create that story to where the woman is the reason why?
Slow down. Where did patriarchy come into existence?
Not sure.
Okay. Let's just say this. Let's say that the way that you appear, this is just your appearance. It has nothing to do with what actually is real in your existence, your appearance. Your appearance says that you might be relative to the indigenous Native American. All right? Your appearance says, certain things about your appearance says that you are probably identified or can identify with people out of Africa. Your appearance says that you can be identified with people out of the South Pacific. All right? Each one of those people, relative to what is called culture, what did they use as a hierarchy for a system of society?
Families? Hold on, can you repeat the question? I'm sorry.
Let me just deal with the answer, all right? If you say families, who is the head of the families out of the groups that I suggested that you might be linked to?
Who's the head of them?
Yeah. The mother. So now, you have to go through all of the different African cultures. You have to go through all of the different Native American cultures. It's not all one culture. You have to go through all of the different South Pacific cultures. I was only identifying you by the way you look. But if you say the mother, what would we call that?
Matriarchal.
Now, at the same time, you were born under a system of society created by people who actually come from the Germanic tribes and also the Roman tribes, all right? The Germanic and the Roman tribes had a system where the family structure relative to society was going to be identified. The head was going to be what?
Male.
Male. That's going to be what? Patriarch. Yes.
You said Germanic and what is the other tribe?
Roman.
Roman. Oh, wow.
But now understand, the Romans come from what group?
The Etruscans.
The Etruscans, but hold on now. Hold on. If you say they come from the Etruscans, the Romans received most of their knowledge from?
Oh, from Greeks.
From the Greeks.
Taylor, look right the word Etruscans.
Etruscans. So you may want to look it up in the dictionary. Do what you're doing. Think through the word and find it. Check with me to make sure you got it correct, and then look it up. Yes, I'm listening.
Right. So the Romans got their knowledge through the Greeks.
Well, they inherited.
Inherited.
The knowledge from the Greeks.
Right.
But the Greeks invented the knowledge from Egypt.
Right.
But they didn't stop in Egypt.
Right.
They actually conquered all the way across, all the way past India. Now, some people say that the Greeks got stopped in India. Tell me the story. Why do the Greeks get stopped? Daniel, what are you looking for? I know, but what are you looking for? What is the question that you're asking that will allow you to go in that dictionary and try to find what you need to find in order to answer the question? What are you saying, David?
Are you in India? Are you referring to Alexander?
And what happens to Alexander?
He ran into the mountains.
No, not Alexander.
Oh.
Alexander goes crazy.
Right.
Oh,
he loses his mental capacities.
Right.
Now.
You can erase Daniel's drawings. Yeah. Not the word.
And then we gotta get back to discipline because I want to finish that. He goes crazy, loses his mind.
Right.
Why did he lose his mind? What happens before he loses his mental ability? What happens?
Somebody died, no food. What happened?
I don't know.
All right. When the Greeks are in what you call Egypt, before they ever head out to India, what happens? See, the Greeks conquer
right.
Egypt
right.
Before the Romans.
Right.
The Romans are still barbarians.
Right.
All right?
Right?
What happens when they conquer, when the Greeks conquer Egypt? And understand what would suggest to us right now that the Greek presence in Africa, I'm not just saying Egypt, I'm saying Africa, was in fact what it was and what happened. What gives us evidence? All right, let me help you, David. You ever go around Ethiopian people?
Rarely.
Rarely. But you have been around people from Ethiopia. All right? There's one group of people from Ethiopia. All of them look like sisters and brothers.
Right.
I don't care if it's 1,000 of them. They all look like sisters and brothers.
Right.
They're going to be about her complexion.
And
they're going to have features similar to Sherry's. Her complexion. So they're going to have sharp features.
Right.
All right?
Yeah, no
problem, I guess. And that's just, how many groups are in Ethiopia? How many races are there in Ethiopia?
That's a whole lot.
How many?
Don't know.
Give me an approximation. So you know these Negroes running around here talking about they're all just Africans.
Right.
You know they knuckleheads.
Hmm.
All right? So let's approximate with 72. 72 different ethnic groups in Ethiopia. Now, tell me about the one group that reminds you of a phenotype out of Italy. And they're not really in Ethiopia. They're right next door to Ethiopia. They're Etrians. Etrians. All right, now, in Ethiopia, you're going to have that group, her color, her phenotype. All right? Who is that group? Now, let me tell you what, when I was a child, there were brothers studying this, and they were running into all kind of difficulty trying to expose their study to black people. The one brother in particular that I'm thinking about, he called them Nigritians. You have never heard of a Nigritian?
No, sir.
Well, this brother called them Nigritians. And he talked about the fact that the Greeks actually went into what you call Ethiopia. They named the place Ethiopia, and they actually amalgamated with the women and created this little small group that you can identify. Now you have Oro. You have the Amharic speakers. You have the Falasha. And we can go on and on. And they're not all Ethiopians. In Nigeria, what are they? Are they all Nigerians? What are they?
I'm Igbo.